The parallax effect is one of those trippy, mind-bending effects that you can do easily in DaVinci Resolve, and you see it in movies, TV shows, and travel videos. And did I say it's easy? Like, it's super easy. So let's get into DaVinci Resolve and I'll show you. First, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification to be updated on the newest videos put out. Now that we're in DaVinci Resolve, first thing you need is a clip. So this clip has to either be moving in towards a subject or moving away from a subject. So we see this clip right here, it's moving forward towards this tower. So the thing to be aware of with this is that we can't actually move out from this clip. You can't like zoom out and make this weird parallax effect. With this clip, you're supposed to like zoom in on it. Problem is, it's also zooming in. So if you add two zoom effects, you're just gonna get like a super zoom and no parallax, and that sucks. So we need to reverse the clip. And to do this, I'm gonna actually jump in Fusion. You can totally do this in the edit tab, but I like the spline better than the curves in this. So that's literally the only reason why I'm doing that. So we jump into the Fusion tab. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna actually retime our speed. So we're gonna hit Control Space and the select tool is gonna pop up. You're gonna type in time and it's gonna pop up, just hit add. It'll add it right there. Click on your time speed node and then go right here to this transform. And it's just gonna add it downstream again. What we're gonna do is we're gonna hit time speed, and then we're gonna click on the inspector tab right here. And we see that it's moving one time speed forward. So all you're gonna do is put a minus there, and it's actually just gonna reverse the time speed. So now that we have this going backwards, we can now push in on the frame to make that parallax effect. To do this, we're gonna click on our transform node. We're gonna add a keyframe. Make sure your playhead's also on zero. We're gonna add keyframes on center, so hit this diamond. And then on size, center is the position and size is the zoom. Now we're gonna go all the way to the end, just like this. And we're going to zoom in more on this clock tower and just reposition it. You wanna be aware of this initial frame. So mainly this is the center. So we're gonna still have it be the center and have it be off center a little. So now, when you play it, you start getting this like warping effect as if the world is coming in on you and you're just focusing intently on this tower. But we can bring this one step further. We can make it a little more smoother and a little more just mind-boggling. So we're gonna go over here to our spline, and this is the reason why I like it, is I can toggle things on, toggle things off, and I can see every single one of my nodes in one place. So we have our transform. So I just turn them on, and I go over here and hit the zoom button. And this ultimately just reframes everything to where I can see it. So now I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna drag this, make a box around it and hit F. And that's gonna add some curves to the whole thing. F is like easy ease in After Effects. So now I'm gonna click off and I want to actually make this curve a little more. So I grab the handle and I move it in. I grab this handle and I move it in like that. So it's more gradual up here. I was making the zoom happen a little faster than the speed. So now I'm gonna toggle the spline off and I'm gonna pull this down right here and we'll just run through and see what we got. You can also do this in camera. You can move closer towards an object while at the same time zooming out, or moving away from the object while zooming in. But that's, you know, that's a little harder. If you can just have a shot like this and zoom in, also looks really great. So there it is. There's the parallax slash vertigo effect in DaVinci Resolve. Let me know in the comments below if you guys would like a basic intro to Fusion. I could totally do that. It'd be sick. Just let me know if you'd be interested in that. But as usual, the video on the top is all about the differences between the free version and the paid version of DaVinci Resolve. And the video on the bottom is a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. But until the next one, peace.